We're asked to write the given subtraction problems symbolically, then calculate the results. So we'll go through each of these examples and first write the symbolic representation of the difference. In the first example, we are given -9 subtracted from -4. Because -9 is being subtracted from -4, we begin with -4 and then subtract -9. This is -9 subtracted from -4. Next we have -9 minus -4. This is typically how we read a subtraction problem. This is -9 minus -4. Next we have -8 subtracted from 7. So again here we're beginning with 7 and then -8 is being subtracted, which is 7 minus -8. Next we have -8 minus 7. Again, this is normally how we read a subtraction problem. This is -8 minus 7. Next we have 9 less than -7. So we begin with -7. We want 9 less than -7, which means we subtract 9. And then finally we have 8 decreased by -4. So we begin with 8. Because we went to decrease this by -4, we need to subtract -4. And now to determine the calculated results, we will write each difference as a sum, then determine the sum. Notice for the first three, we are subtracting a negative. Subtracting a negative is equivalent to adding a positive. So -4 minus -9 is equivalent to -4 plus 9. And now let's determine this sum using the number line. We first model -4 on the number line by starting at 0 and moving left 4 units to -4. So we start at 0, move left 4 units to -4. And now from here, because we are adding positive 9, we move right 9 units from -4. Starting at -4, if we move right 4 units, we're back at 0. We need to move right 5 more units to +5 on the number line. -4 minus -9 equals -4 plus 9, which equals +5. This is the calculated result. Now if we want to use the formal rules for adding integers though, because we're adding integers with different signs, we first take the absolute value of both integers. So we have the absolute value of -4, which is 4, the absolute value of 9, which is 9, and we subtract the smaller value from the larger value, which is 9 minus 4, which equals 5, but the sign of the sum is the sign of the integer with the larger absolute value. So because the positive 9 has the larger absolute value, we know the sum is +5. This should also make sense because the positive 9 is outweighing the -4. Next we have -9 minus -4, which is equivalent to -9 plus 4. So again, -9 minus -4 is equivalent to -9 plus 4. On the number line, we first model -9 by starting at 0 and moving left 9 units to -9. Because we're adding 4, we move right 4 units from -9. So if we move right 4 units from -9, this takes us to -5. -9 minus -4 equals -9 plus 4, which equals -5. Using the formal rules for adding integers, again, the first step is to determine the absolute value of both integers. The absolute value of -9 is 9. The absolute value of +4 is 4. And now we subtract the smaller value from the larger value. 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. And the sign of the sum is the sign of the number with the larger absolute value. -9 has a larger absolute value, which means -9 plus 4 is not 5, but -5. The next difference is 7 minus -8. 7 minus -8 is equivalent to 7 plus +8, which we know is equal to +15. Next we have -8 minus 7. Subtracting a positive is equivalent to adding a negative, and therefore -8 minus 7 is equal to negative 8 plus negative 7. To model this on the number line, we begin by modeling negative 8 by starting at 0 and moving left 8 units to negative 8. And then because we're adding negative 7 or subtracting positive 7, we move left 7 units from negative 8. Which brings us to negative 15 on the number line. Negative 8 minus 7 equals negative 8 plus negative 7, which equals negative 15. Using the formal rules, because we're adding integers with the same sign, we add the absolute values of the two integers and then keep the common sign. The absolute value of negative 8 is 8. The absolute value of negative 7 is 7. 8 plus 7 is equal to 15, but because we're adding two negative integers, the sum is not positive 15, the sum is negative 15. The next example is very similar. Negative 7 minus 9 is equivalent to negative 7 plus negative 9. On the number line, we first model negative 7 by moving left 7 units from 0 to negative 7. Then because we're adding negative 9, we move left 9 units from negative 7. So if we move 9 units to the left of negative 7, we are at negative 16 on the number line, which is the sum as well as the difference. And again, using the formal rules, because we're adding integers with the same sign, we add their absolute values and keep the common sign. The absolute value of negative 7 is 7. The absolute value of negative 9 is 9. 7 plus 9 is equal to 16. But because we're adding two negative integers, the sum is negative 16. And for the last example, we have 8 minus negative 4. Again, subtracting a negative is equivalent to adding a positive, which means 8 minus negative 4 is equal to 8 plus positive 4, which we know is equal to positive 12. I hope you found this helpful.